Find what works for you. Celtx has been working for me for years, but you know, you gotta find what works for you. I like this, it's free, and you can use it on any on any computer.
I'm on a journey to create the greatest movie experience in the world. While I'm carving out my filmmaking entrepreneurial path, I want to help you create yours. Let's make some movies. Hello everyone, James Martin here. I'm here to help filmmakers to succeed in their career and to make better movies. Today I'm doing a very special tutorial on a very special script software that I've been using for the longest time. This was introduced to me back in film school. I use the software on all my projects right now. It's free and it's available for Mac as well as PC, and that's called Celtx. So today I'm going through a step-by-step tutorial to help you to create your very first script. We're going to go through the software itself, how to download it, all the special features underneath it, how it can help keep you organized and keep all your components together and keep it consistent. It's very important that when you're writing a script that you have good software to help you keep organized, that's easy to use, as well as it's formatted properly for your scripts so that professionals can look at it. It really does make a difference. So let's get right into the tutorial. All right, so once you open up the Celtx software, you're gonna open up to a window just like this. So as you can see, so we get automatically started off with some project templates. So you could start off with a film script or audio visual. You could write a theater play, you could write an audio play, storybooks, comic book, or just do some text. By the way, keep in mind that it will be advertising a lot to get the pro version of Celtx. This is completely up to you. To be perfectly honest, I don't use the pro version of Celtx only because the free version has given me everything I could possibly need, but it does give you additional features such as you can use it on your phone, you can share it with other people and have team members if there's, let's say, multiple writers involved. So it's kind of helpful for that part. And of course, it keeps tabs on your more recent projects. So you get a little sneak peek in some scripts that I've been working on too. But right now we're gonna open up a film script. So this is what you get to see. So just to sort of walk you through what we're gonna see at the moment. So we have the project library. This is pretty straightforward. It keeps all your different files under this one project, you know, organized. So we have the catalog, which I'm going to show you in a second, and then we can get started with the screenplay, but we can also add on other projects if you wanted to just work on other stuff at the same time. So we also have scenes. So every time you write a scene, the scene titles are just going to be added onto here, and this just helps keep you organized. It's sort of like chapters in your book where you can automatically jump straight to a scene if you want to edit it and do other stuff. And on the right-hand side, we have notes. If you're writing a script and you need to add notes to particular scenes to keep you on track, you can also include your medium. So this is like conceptual art. This is also music. This is test clips. Breakdown. So this categorizes different scenes and different things involved in your script. So right now, I'm just going to go back to notes. So now, you see this where it says scene heading? This is important because it's going to tell you the primary function of what it is that you're typing out. This is important for format purposes, and I'm going to show you how. So right now it gives you the scene heading, which is important because you start your scripts off with a scene heading. So right now I'm just going to type in something for the scene. Now, I wanted to show you something kind of cool. You see in this bottom right-hand corner where you have tab and then action and then enter and then action. So this is one of the things I love about Celtx. So it's meant to make your life as easy as possible. So it already shows you that if you hit those particular command buttons on your laptop or keyboard or wherever, it automatically will format your next text to that particular format. So what does it mean by action? So I'm going to press enter.
So now I'm writing for action. This is, what is your character doing? What is happening? What is happening in the scene? The description, etc. So for instance, I might write something like this. Right, just a very basic description. So that's for, as I said, describing the scene, etc. So it keeps it formatted for that. So as you notice, action and the scene heading are very different because they're serving two different purposes. Now, you may notice that on the very bottom, if I press the tab button, I start writing for characters. Now, before I do that, what it's going to do, so I'm going to press action again, because what I can do is, let's say I write in man as our character. If I press tab, it automatically creates a character known as the man. So it's formatted specifically for the character. What you can also do is, once you have that, I'm just going to sort of start over. I can also go into action. Then I can go up here and see where it says character. Automatically, it can format it to character. So I'm going to just do the same thing. So man. Before I move on, you notice how the master catalog has one beside it? So that's important because the master catalog is basically documenting everything that you do and organizing it for you automatically. And I'm going to show you that in a moment. Right now, so if you go to man, if you notice, if we press dialogue, we start writing dialogue. I apologize if my typing is a bit messy. I'm literally typing this out with one hand. So we create some dialogue. I can also come up here, press enter, and press my parentheses, and it automatically creates a form of parentheses. So I don't know, sipping on morning tea. I don't know if all of you do that when you first wake up in the morning. So it keeps that for us automatically. And then I'm just gonna press enter, which means we're automatically going to create a character, but I'm going to press enter again, so we go into action. Now, when I come up here, we can choose between all of these options. So scene heading, that's what we just saw here. Action, so that's describing what your character is doing, the blocking, the scene, etc. Character, that's the character we're identifying. The dialogue, that's what the character is saying. Parentheses, that's sort of right, what this is, which is describing what's happening while the dialogue is being said. Transitions, you can add a transition as sort of notes for your editing if that's something important. Because maybe you might want to direct, and maybe the way you're going to direct and do shots will affect the editing, and there's a very specific way you want to do that. So you can create the transition. You can also write in your shots. So this is extremely helpful if you're both writing and directing your movie, story, whatever it is. So you can start writing your shots right into the script to keep that sort of organized, or you can just write some text. And then of course I can just get started with my next scene. And notice how as I start writing, it automatically starts suggesting what the next, what I'm trying to write in, right? Because let's say I want to get started by writing my character's name. I'm just going to press the letter M, and it automatically knows that I'm trying to think of the character man. And if it wants me to suggest, if it wants to suggest other characters, again, it keeps it sort of organized. And then of course we have the basic scene descriptions down here. Now I want to show you the master catalog that I've been talking about for quite some time. So if we go here, as I said, the master catalog keeps tabs on everything that is happening in your story, but you can also write in more information. So right now we have a character, right? That's our category. What I love so much is it gives you other information that you can fill out if you want to. So you could be creating a character and start writing in more details. And even if you have all the details figured out, when you put this in here, it keeps it all together. So you can also print this off and give your character sheets over to your actors so that they have the same information. So you can write in the character tag so you can find it easily. You can put in the full name if you want to. Attach the media for guidance, description, and it automatically shows you which scenes this character is in. Now this actor tab over here, it basically helps you figure out which actor you want for your story. So let's say you've already done casting. What you can do, and this really helps with doing logistics especially, so I'm going to add an item, and then it gives me a bunch of different options. So I can choose between wardrobe, I can choose music and production notes, livestock, extras, character, but right now we're going to go to actor. And right now I'm just going to type in an actor. Shout out to Will Smith, you're the best. But let's just assume that Will Smith is on the project, which would be awesome. I can go down to actor, and because Will Smith is already an actor in my master catalog, I can attach him and attach that character tab so I can have that organized. But if we go down here, we can start writing in character traits, physical descriptions, motivation, character background. This really just helps you figure out and really get into the mindset of what it is that you're writing, right? And if I go into actor, same thing. This gives you all the necessary information that you can write regarding the actor and all the other characters too. And again, it keeps all this organized for you, so it's super helpful. So now we can go to our screenplay. Next thing I want to show you are these tabs down here, but I'm going to show you them in sort of reverse order, and I'm going to explain that to you in a moment. So we start off with script. So obviously this is where we're going to write the script. Reports keeps all the information in one place, which is nice. Title page. This is exactly what you think it is. This is the title of your script, so it helps you keep that organized as well. So you're writing your screenplay, the title of your project, the name, and the names of the writers involved. Maybe this is based on an existing story or some other event. You can write that information down here. Copyright, this is where you can put in your copyright information if you have copyright information. If you're not sure about copyright, here's just my suggestion, just write your name in. Write your name, and I write in your production company if you have a production company. All right. And then contact information. Maybe you're trying to sell this to a production company. Maybe you're trying to sell this off to someone. You want to make sure that if they want to work on your script, that they can contact you. So this is where you put in just your contact information. So this is where you'll put in your email and your phone number. And if you're with like a particular agency or anything like that, you'd put that information down as well. Just realized I didn't put in my name and author. And I'm just going to change this to, let's say, the day. All right, so obviously this is just for example purposes, but it gives you an idea of what you can start writing in your title page. Index card. So what I love about this is essentially your beat sheet. If you don't know what a beat sheet is, this is where you start sort of getting an overview on your story. So you write in your scenes and start describing what those scenes are, what's the purpose of the scene, and then scene two, etc., etc., etc. And this way you can very quickly see, okay, so where is the story going? Do I need to add scenes? Do I need to take away scenes? Do I need to change scenes? So it helps you sort of start from the outside in, because once you have your scenes figured out, you can go to your script, right? And then you can start, you know, fine-tuning those scenes. So that's what an index card does. Scratchpad. This allows you to keep notes while you're writing your script at the same time. So you can experiment with dialogue, experiment with different things, and then just bounce back between the script and your notes. Now, this is the reason why I wanted to show you this backwards, and this is typeset. What this does is it takes all the information from your script and formats it to exactly what it should be and exactly where you're going to see once you've saved it to a PDF or printed it. So as you can see, here's page one, The Day by James Martin, and here's all the information there. So that's page one, as you can see. And then we go straight to page two, and as you can see, it's all formatted to proper industry standards so we can continue to move forward, and it shows you how many pages. right? But just keep in mind that page one will include the title page. So if it seems like it's one page longer, that's just because you are including the title page as well as the script itself. So don't worry. But I also like this because it keeps you an idea on, you know, you could be writing away till the day's gone by with your script and you start to lose track as to, geez, I wonder how long this script is so far. Well, you go straight to typeset and it shows you, okay, so 2 pages, but it could easily get to, you know, 5 pages, 10 pages, 30 pages, 60 pages. And that way it just helps you make sure that, like, okay, maybe this is getting a little long, maybe it's not long enough. Maybe it's short, maybe it's not short enough, etc. And then once you're happy with that, you just save it as a PDF. It just saves as a PDF file on your computer, or you can print this out. So it helps you that way. All right, so I hope this helps you out. This is sort of like a run through on Celtx. This is the script software that I use for literally the last several years on all my projects. And just, I hope this helps you out as well. The important thing that you need to remember is if this script software does not fit you, if you find it, you know, not as comfortable to use as, let's say, other softwares, then by all means, use another software. Find what works for you. Celtx has been working for me for years, but, you know, you gotta find what works for you. I like this, it's free, and you can use it on any computer. So, hope this works out for you, and good luck with your projects.
And that's it. I hope this tutorial helped you out. And if it did, please smash that like button and share this to other filmmakers so that they can get the same help as well. And by the way, if you're interested in learning about other free software, maybe Celtx isn't a good fit for you. And if not, that's fine. If you're looking at other software, I have an amazing video on my top 5 free script softwares that you can download, and I'll link it up in the cards up above and in the description below. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel and turn on those notification bells so you don't miss a single upload. We post every single week to help you not only enjoy the filmmaking life, but also how to improve it. Very exciting. So, good luck with your movies, and I will see you next time.